This green and serene surrounding is part of one of India's most popular automobile companies. Welcome to the sacred forest. The 18 ponds, the marshland, the grassland, the wetland, and the woodland are part of the TVS Motor Company's factory in Hosur. The sacred forest spreads over 50 acres of TVS Motor's Hosur facility that manufactures two- and three-wheelers. The residents of this forest include the long-legged grey herons, the Indian grey hornbill, the spot-billed pelican, the little cormorant, the Indian darter, the night heron, the white-browed wagtail, the Indian moorhen, soft-shell tortoises, freshwater turtles, snakes including the cobra, the Russell's viper, the saw-scale viper and common crate, butterflies and dragonflies. It is also home to a few endangered species such as Indian pangolin, grey slender loris and otters. How did this forest come into existence? In the mid-90s, the company's premises had an empty patch that spread across 50 acres. While various departments of the company were eyeing that piece of land for their expansion, Venu Srinivasan, who was the managing director of the company at that point in time, thought otherwise. He took out a pen and drew a circle encapsulating the 50-acre area and called it a sacred area where no department has any claim. Venu Srinivasan recalls, "The area around the factory was barren. We wanted to use this land for creating some green cover, install rainwater harvesting systems, and recharge groundwater for our bore wells. One thing led to another, and what we have today is a biosphere." Soon the place became home to some of the most exotic flora and fauna. A separate team takes care of the forest. The team includes P. Venkateshan, the Vice President Civil, tells us more about the reasons behind such an investment.
We are deep inside the forest of a TVS Motor Company. A 50 acre of sacred forest developed within a 300 acre of manufacturing plant. This sacred forest is the brainchild of our chairman, Mr. Venu Srinivasan. 20 years back, this project was given to us. We harvested all the rainwater from the factory, got into various water bodies like ponds, pools, check dams, streams, etc., and planted lots of native trees, herbs, shrubs, grasses, etc., so that they can support the local fauna. Today, we have more than 442 species of vegetation supporting equal number of animals. Also, the flagship bird of us is the painter storks. They come every winter, breed here and go back. More than 14 different water birds are coming here and breeding. This entire place is now a heaven for all the local species of birds and animals.
Justin Ahimas, World Wildlife Fund veteran.
First of all, it is something that is much in need, because we are devastating our areas due to development and whatnot, pollution, so many other things. These factors are devastating the land, destroying the habitat, ruining forests. These forests and habitats are what brings in wildlife. And a combination of forest, habitat and wildlife is what creates a healthy ecosystem. Different habitats support different castes of wildlife. So while a grassland may support, say, 15 or 18 species, a wetland supports another 25. So if you have both grassland and wetland, you have that many more species. So to increase the biodiversity here, and that is important, we are creating different types of habitats. We've got woodland, which is forest that you see around you. We have wetlands, all the ponds and little rivers and rivulets and streams that we are creating. You have dry habitats, scrubland, where you have thorny plants. It's largely dry, largely very rocky. But there are animals that live particularly in that kind of habitat, and they prefer that kind of habitat. We also have marshland. Marshland is a place where you have water flooding and water logging with plants growing in them, especially reeds and rushes like bulrushes and stuff. There are birds that nest in these kind of places, like the white-breasted water hen, the purple swamp hen. These birds use these kinds of marshland to breed in. So when you have three or four or five different types of habitats, you have that many more different kinds of wildlife, that the biodiversity of your area increases. And biodiversity is the key to a healthy ecosystem.
Students from nearby schools visit the forest and see for themselves how nature should be respected and preserved. In the Mysore factory, Venu Srinivasan has also launched a formal 3-year curriculum covering relevant environmental aspects. To know more about this unique project, click the link in the description box below.